are going to hear a story named Virtually True. It is written by Paul Stewart. The story is about a computer game and two boys and their relation with the real world. It is a science fiction. As the title of the story suggests itself, the story has a thin line between virtual and real world. The complete story revolves around the protagonist, Sebastian Salch, whose memory got saved in computer. When he met with an accident and his head bangs on the laptop while playing Psycho Drive games. Later, this game was bought by Michael and his father in computer film. Later, Sebastian was saved by Michael while playing game. Isn't it an interesting story? So first of all, let's start with the characters in the story. The first character is Sebastian Salch. He is the main character of the story, who is 14 years old. He was a brilliant-minded person who loves to play games. He kept on trying until he gets success and never loses hope. He had a polite nature, as he had written all the messages to Michael in a good language. He was kind-hearted and thankful person who thanked Michael through an email and asked him to keep those games with himself as a gift from him. Now, the second character with whom we come across is Michael. Michael was a boy who had a passion for computer and technology, who loves to play computer games, especially the virtual games. The way he helped Sebastian in Escape shows his friendly nature and kind heart. He was sentimental as he felt guilty when he was not able to save Sebastian in third level. The third character is Michael's father. He was nerdy about computer, means he was very passionate about it. He loved the new technology. He always used to say that computer never lost their memory, which proved right later. He was gentle father and loves his son as he gifted Michael computer and bought the latest version of computer in the fair. Now, we should begin with the story. Here, Michael is the narrator of the story. The story starts with a boy named Michael who read an article in the newspaper about a miracle recovery. It was about a boy whose condition was critical but stable. He had been recovered from coma. Michael recollects his memory about the boy who was mentioned in the newspaper. It was in fact Sebastian Salch, who he had met a week ago while playing online virtual games. This all started in the computer fair when Michael's father, who was passionate about computers, bought him a new computer preloaded with games. When he was playing the game Wild West, he becomes sheriff and is challenged by black-eyed Jed to a duel. He meets a second sheriff whom he was asked to go with. Unfortunately, the second sheriff gets shot by the villains and the game ends. Later on, he gets a printout which read, "I am Sebastian Salch. Try playing Dragon Quest." In Dragon Quest, his task was to save the Princess Aurora from the wicked dragon and collect the wicked creature's treasure along the way. He had the help of the second knight, who was revealed to be Sebastian. Later on in the game, Sebastian was killed. The game ended with a printer displaying a message asking him not to give up and try playing the next game, Jailbreak. In Jailbreak, his mission was to escape with a prisoner, and he knew it was Sebastian again. They broke out of jail, ran to the roof as door shut behind them. The helicopter arrived as they reached the roof. They got into the helicopter. As they took off, Sebastian fell off the helicopter and the game ends. Later on, he plays the game many times but the printout doesn't come. After some days, the printer shows a message telling him that the helicopter was a better choice. Try playing Warzone. He knew it was Sebastian again. Sebastian had also promised him that he would not trouble him again through the message if this didn't work out. He jumped right into the game. He found himself in some kind of a city scarred by battle bounds. He knew that he had to save Sebastian. They ran together to an abandoned jeep which was near the destroyed stone. They sat in the jeep and started driving it. They went toward the helicopter when the tank started chasing them. As soon as it came to their view, Sebastian stopped the jeep suddenly. The jeep went into a spin and Michael leapt into the helicopter. Sebastian does not enter the helicopter at this point. Michael waits and yells at him to come into helicopter, but Sebastian doesn't move. Moment later, the tank collides with the jeep and Sebastian is thrown into the helicopter. They fly into cloud and the game ends. When he removes his visor, he comes to know that he has got the high score. He had hit the jackpot with a score of 40 million and finally complete the game. Michael wanted now to cross-check the facts. He got out of the train and searched the net for some details. He found out what he was looking for. Apparently, at the time of the accident, Sebastian was using his laptop to play one of the Psycho Drive game that Michael had bought. Michael realized that Sebastian's memory had been stored on disk when Sebastian had banged his head on the laptop in the accident. But still, Michael had a question that how did the memory of Sebastian end up in the narrator's computer? This was also solved later as Michael came to know that when Sebastian had been in the hospital, someone had stolen the game and sold them. Michael must have bought those games in the computer fair. When Michael opened his computer, there was a message from Sebastian that said, "Dear Michael, thank you. I'm not sure how it happened, but you saved my life. Let's meet up soon. Cheers. Save. Please keep the games. You have earned them." This was a real and direct message from the real Sebastian. It was clear that, relieving the accident, something wonderful had happened. But then again, what can someone say about miracles? And what is true or what is virtual too? No one can say with finality. Michael had undergone through an experience that proved to be virtually true. Thank you.